The American Printing House for the Blind presents ENVISION I, Vision Enhancement Program Using Distance Devices. Here are some scenes of ENVISION in action.
Is it my curtain call already? Well, let's see. Where do I start? Oh, yes. Allow me to introduce myself. I'm Emmy Brightfeather, also known as Emmy the Emu, because, well, I am Emu. Please don't confuse me with those sluggish ostriches. Heavens, they can't even speak English. And don't get me started on their table manners.
Psst, Emmy, get on the topic. You're supposed to talk about ENVISION.
Who, me? You're telling me, Emmy, your diva, your star, that I should be... I nearly forgot. Dear friends, we are gathered here together to join you with information about my favorite topic, the ENVISION program. Yay! ENVISION 1. Teaching Skills for Using Handheld Distance Devices by the American Printing House for the Blind. Oh, ENVISION is so cool. It has stories about my town, Emuville, and about my brothers, Ernest and Ethan, and me. But don't just go off on your own to use ENVISION. Students like me will do better if you take a team approach. Here's one of my favorite people, Dr. Paul Byther, my optometrist. He is here to tell you why you need to use a team approach when using the ENVISION program.
Hi, I'm Dr. Paul Byther, a low vision optometrist in Indianapolis, Indiana, and I'd like to share with you some information regarding the ENVISION program, a curriculum that has been developed by the American Printing House for the Blind as a tool to help visually impaired children integrate the use of low vision devices into classroom and extracurricular activities. In order to achieve the best outcome for a visually impaired student, it is important that several key individuals work together as part of an eye care team. This group of individuals includes parents, teachers for the visually impaired, other classroom teachers, the low vision clinician, and the student. Parents and teachers can contribute to the process by offering observations regarding the student's performance in various settings, including situations when he functions well, and situations when the student appears to be having difficulty performing certain tasks. The low vision clinician will take careful measurements of the student's vision and make recommendations, including prescription eyewear such as glasses or contact lenses, and low vision devices such as magnifiers, monoculars, or special lighting requirements. The student will then work with the recommended devices with the assistance of teachers and parents to help him learn how to use them well and to reinforce techniques that he has learned in his training. And ideally, those who are working closely with the student in his school and home environment will communicate back with the low vision clinician to report successes or difficulties encountered with the recommended devices. The ENVISION program includes an array of low vision devices, including several magnifiers and monoculars. These are intended only for use in training students between the time that they have a low vision evaluation and the time that they receive the recommended prescriptive devices from the clinician. As soon as the student has received his recommended devices, any further training should be conducted with those devices. I would like to emphasize the necessity of having a low vision evaluation by an experienced low vision practitioner before beginning a training program. Each student's needs should be carefully assessed in a low vision evaluation in order to receive the optimum combination of eyewear and magnification devices for best visual function. No one should embark on using the ENVISION program materials prior to seeking such professional consultation.
It's important when using ENVISION to have a good working relationship with the low vision optometrist in your area, because your student should have had a low vision evaluation and recommendation for a telescope before using the ENVISION program. Also, your optometrist can answer important questions like this. Hey, Dr. Byther, If the teacher thinks a recommended telescope isn't working for a certain child, what would you do?
Yes, we might consider a different device, or we might consider having the student sit closer, or depending on the nature of the contrast of the materials that are being used, it might be necessary to suggest something different for the teacher to work with in presenting materials that would be easier for that student to see.
That's good advice, Dr. B. Thanks a bunch. Your student will do better if you and the optometrist talk to each other about your student's needs and progress. So please, do it for us. And while you're at it, build a good relationship with your classroom teacher, too. She can really help you out. Here is my teacher, Ms. Strotman, helping Brandon by talking to his classroom teacher. They're talking about his telescope and how he should use it to see the blackboard.
Would you show me how?
Sure.
The correct handling?
Yes, I would. It always goes around the neck because, you know, kids Brandon's age tend to drop things occasionally, and the soft end goes against the eye. Find a point. Usually what we ask Brandon to do is find the point first visually without this, and then after he finds it, to bring this up and then focus it slightly here. And if he's having a problem focusing it, you can do that. It's pretty easy to do once you get the hang of it. So that's basically it, and keeping it safe. But we really, really need the team approach. I think if he just uses it with me, he's never going to get the opportunity to really get familiar enough with it and comfortable enough with it in, you know, classroom situations. So I would really appreciate it. Maybe if you could even set up a lesson for him.
Okay. Anything that's helpful to Brandon is always welcome in my classroom. So
okay.
I just needed to know how to use it properly, or how he should be using it properly.
Okay, that should do it.
So now you've built great relationships with other members of your student's ENVISION team. It's time now to look inside the ENVISION I tote bag. Do you know what's in it? Let's talk about the tools provided with ENVISION I. So, okay, you've got your regular stuff, like teacher's manuals, distance cards, roll busters, very important, those roll busters. You've got information and referral forms. And what's this? Is this what I think it is? Ah! I don't believe it! An imposter! What the heck is she doing here? Brrr! There is only one Emmy, and that's me. Humph. Okay, now that we've cleared that up, how do you get started with ENVISION? First, meet with your student and fill out the student information sheet. Remember to smile, too. Once you're familiar with what your student needs, then there are other things to find out, like, does your student know the parts of the telescope? Does she understand the concept of in focus? Does she know how to hold it? Watch as Ms. Strodman introduces the telescope to my friend Daisy Lee.
Lens caps on it, covers, and you need to take both of these off, and then I'll show you how to do it. They're just kind of a rubber cap. They come off very easily. Okay, want to try it?
Sure.
Why don't you try taking this one off? When you hold it, you've got to hold it firmly so that you don't drop it, okay? And this is called a lanyard, and this hooks on to this little hole right here, and whenever you're using it, I want you to put this around your neck so that you won't drop this, okay? You have to be very careful of it. Go ahead and slip that around your neck. And when you hold it, first of all, let's clean it. Let's make sure it's clean, okay? Take just kind of eyeball it and make sure there's not any dust on it. And you can take this and just lightly rub it, okay?
Okay.
Want to try it? Let me tell you about the parts of this monocular. The part that is closest to this is called the ocular end. Okay.
And
this
is.
Does your student understand the concept of in focus? It's important to teach in focus before beginning ENVISION I training.
Okay. And in order to focus, that's what we're going to try next. You're going to hold it up to your eye, and you're going to move this objective end just a little bit until things are in focus. You know what it means to be out of focus?
Like you're not focused and
that you can't, right, it isn't clear. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Well, go ahead and try holding that up to your eye. You need to turn it so that the other end is closer to your eye, the one we talked about. Here, let me show you. Okay?
The soft end.
The soft end is going to be closer to your eye. And I want you to hold it so that it, your hand is around it so you have a firm grip on it. Okay?
Yeah.
Great. So you can use your right hand and your right eye. And if you're having a problem focusing, let me know. Do you have a target in mind that you're looking at?
Yeah, that red thing.
Okay, great. And tell me if it's coming in focus. If not, I can focus it for you the first time, and then we can go from there.
Try this one.
You also want your student to care for the monocular properly.
See, now it won't roll. It's like a mini backpack. Isn't that cute? Pretty cute. Yeah, you could. You could put that. Here's a strap, and it could Velcro to your desk. You know what I mean? This part comes on.
If your student needs motivation to learn to use his telescopes, there are some really cool stories to stir up his interest.
And the name of the story is Emmy Finds a Curious Tube. So I want you just to listen for a minute, okay?
Okay.
Not so very long ago, out in the warm desert wilderness of Australia, there lived a large, colorful bird. She was green and had a yellow head and stood as tall as a human. Her name was Emmy. Emmy was an emu, a very large bird with glorious feathers. Her cousins were brown with blue heads.
Makes the world
and they were
clearer
and more beautiful. They have stopped calling Emmy names. Now they just call her Emmy, the beautiful emu.
I just love how this story ends. Isn't Brandon a cutie?
Boy, Brandon sure was embarrassed by that kiss from Emmy. Look at him covering his face like that.
Once you have your student's attention, you can start teaching him stuff. Here's Brandon learning how to locate.
Right. Anytime you want.
Okay. Brandon, while you're looking through the binocular, I want you to tell me what Emmy is doing.
Okay.
What's she doing? Can you tell?
Opening and closing her mouth.
Great.
Yeah.
Okay, I want you to watch carefully. I'm going to move her just a little bit. What's she doing now? Can you tell? What's she doing? Can you tell what she's doing?
Yes.
What is it?
Looks like she's eating your hair.
Good.
After your student learns to locate, you can use ENVISION I to teach him how to scan. Here are Ms. Strodman and Preston working together.
38783. Uh-huh.
A town sign.
Okay.
417.
Uh-huh.
6.
Good. What picture comes after the 90?
Headlight.
Good. All right. Terrific.
These are the distance cards that come in each ENVISION program. They are scientifically designed to help you teach your student location and scanning skills. They are waterproof, so you can use them outside for orientation and mobility skill building. Once Preston learns how to scan, his teacher will teach him to trace.
All right, we're going to try some tracing. And I'd like you to find the curvy line on the back blackboard. Start at the right at the left hand side and trace all the way across the blackboard to the end. And the end.
I found the end.
Great. Can you trace all the way backwards?
Okay.
Perfect. Great.
Your students can use scanning and tracing for really fun stuff. Here's Brandon looking at cool things in the hallway at his school.
Parrots.
Great.
I have no clue what that is.
Okay.
Fish.
And here he is using his telescope for scanning outside.
Car or van that is right next to the red car?
Yeah.
What is next to it?
Van.
What
which
color?
Which side, right or left?
Do right.
It's on the right side. What color is it?
White, blue.
All right. Can you read what is on the front of that band?
GMC.
GMC. Great job. You're doing great.
Preston is using his telescope at a fast food restaurant to read the menu. Once he reads the items on the menu, he can make his selection. How about extra crispy, Preston? Once your student masters scanning and tracing, he can learn to track.
First of all, can you see the motion of those cars out there on the street?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Now let's see if you can line up your telescope, find where those cars are.
There's one.
Got it? And then the next one that comes by, you see if
There's
you can
one.
Follow it. Let's see if you can keep it and follow it until it disappears.
Gone in at trees.
All right. That was really good. Looks like you followed it really well.
I can't guess.
Andrew, you're doing a really good job with those low vision devices. Are you feeling
Thank
pretty
you.
Good about them? Good. Well, you keep up the good work.
Did you see how Dr. Byther congratulated Andrew? It's important to let your student know when he does well. That's why ENVISION has a certificate of completion to give to your student when he completes the ENVISION training program. It is of utmost importance that when the student completes the ENVISION program, you, the teacher, send a report back to the clinician so he or she can see how the student is getting along with the recommended telescope. By using the enclosed report to the clinician, you can give him the information he needs to finalize the prescription. That final step is so important. Here's Dr. Byther finalizing a prescription for Andrew. He really needs and uses the report from Andrew's teacher, Mrs. Wright.
It appears he's still having some difficulty with some of his classroom's activity with his monocular.
Yeah, some of the far distance.
Okay. And he's sitting at about 15 feet.
In addition to the ENVISION I program, the American Printing House for the Blind offers educators training in how to use the product. If your region needs training on the ENVISION program, please call the American Printing House for the Blind. That number is 800-223-1839. Ask to speak to field services. Now go have fun with ENVISION and visit Emuville and all its wacky inhabitants.
Hey, I am Emmy the Emu, and I know a thing or two. Like how to use magnifiers, and I can use telescopes too. Hey, you may ask how I learned this stuff. No, it was not hard, no, it was not tough. I study with ENVISION, it's easy, that is true. I got smart with ENVISION, even if I'm an emu. I'm Emmy the Emu.
Starring Andrew Holyoke, student, Preston Llewellyn, student, Daisy Lee Summerlin, student, Tessa Wright, classroom teacher, Margot Stratman, TBI, Wendy Simmons, classroom teacher, John Lord, principal. Special thanks to Maple Ridge Elementary School, Pendleton, Indiana, Hancock Middle School, Charlottesville, Indiana. Additional thanks to Paul Byther, OD, Indianapolis, Indiana, Emmy the Emu Puppet, voice characterization by Olivia Klotz, played by Sandy Baker, Emmy the Emu Song, written by Elaine Kitchell, performed by Madeline Grace Doherty, script written by Elaine Kitchell. Produced by Sandy Baker. Edited by Elaine Kitchell, Sandy Baker, Brian Doherty. Photography, videography, and sound by Alan Smithy. Additional thanks to Hancock South Madison Joint Services, Greenfield, Indiana. KFC, Greenfield, Indiana. Special thanks to the San Carlos Apache Nation.